Hello, everyone. Thank you for being here tonight. We had a great time. The students who are on stage here tonight, all the students, have worked so hard since January preparing for tonight's performance. So please join me in giving them one more round of applause. I wish I could take credit for the wonderful choreography that you saw tonight, but the gift of the dance was not something that I was given. It would look nothing like what you saw tonight. So I would like to take a minute to thank the choreographers, the student choreographers who taught the dances that you saw tonight. They really get a good idea of what it is like to stand before a room of high schoolers every day. And they quickly realize that's not the easiest job in the world. So I want to thank them for their help in adding to tonight's concert. So choreographers, where are you? Come out and take your clap. And Messing Gallery, which is hosted by the Arts Backers. And as you heard earlier in the program, we are accepting donations tonight for shoot crew water projects. So there is a donation container at the reception, and we thank you for your support. Sitting on the stage are the 15 seniors in the class of 2018. They only have 4 days left of high school. It seems like just yesterday, I was telling them before the concert started, that they were walking through my door as timid freshmen. They are no longer timid. They are a wonderful group of people. And I don't know if it's really hit you or not, but you just sang your last high school final performance. Except for Brown Church, the one left. Most of these students have performed for 4 years of their high school career. Others found their way to me a little bit later, but I'm glad they found their way to my classroom. Inside your program, you will find an insert prepared by these wonderful men and women. It gives you just a glimpse at what they have valued the most about singing in high school, some of their favorite memories, and some special words to their families and friends. And we're gonna revisit a few of those here in just a little bit. So in just a few minutes after I give one of the awards here, I'm going to spend a couple hours reflecting with them upon the last 4 years. Oh, you all laugh. I'm just telling you. They know I can go for a long. Yes. And I asked them, do you want a long talk or a short talk? And their answer said, they said long. Maybe I won't go that long, but they can tell you anybody likes talking. When I get started, sometimes I just keep going and going and going. But last night at the conclusion of the concert, I presented the grade level awards for students in grades 9 through 11. And so tonight I have the privilege of presenting the highest musical award in honor that a senior student in the vocal music program can achieve, the National School Choral Award. This award is presented annually to a senior or seniors who have given 4 years of exemplary service to the MICDS choral program. The certificate reads, in recognition of superior merit, ability, and achievement of outstanding contributions to the success of the school choral program and of an unusual degree of loyalty, cooperation, and high quality of conduct by the general consent of the music faculty, school officials, and others. This year's recipient has performed with the St. Louis Metro District Honor Choir 3 years of their high school career, earned superior ratings at the Mission District and State Music Festivals, and in fact today, this student traveled to Columbia early this morning to perform at the State Music Festival, receiving the top rating possible. They have performed with the 2017 and 2018 Missouri All-State Choir, which is quite an accomplishment considering only 4 students are selected per voice part from the entire St. Louis metro area. And most recently, the student performed with the 2018 American Choral Directors Association Southwest National Honor Choir in Oklahoma City. I am pleased to present the National School Choral Award to Izzy Essie. you're looking for a time that might be a good time to leave if you wanted to, this would be the time to make that exit. So I'm giving you the opportunity here. You're not going to offend me, or you're not going to offend, well, you might offend them, but leave, you might be missing the best part of the show, because they'll tell you, you don't know what's going to come out of my mouth. And I think that's kind of what they're hoping for here just a little bit. So if you wish to leave, you go to move and leave, and I'm going to come over and sit with you all. Is that good? Feels kind of weird to me saying, give me this little talk, and then I'm going to say, I'll see you Monday. But we're going to be fine. So, time for the last concert. How was it? Feel like it. I know you're going to get one. No, you think I say this to every senior class, and I do, but it really is. It's true. You're a very special class. I remember you walking through my doors, first day of school, some of you with this look of fear in your eyes. My guess was that J-Rob told you that I'm the no-nonsense.
Oh, that's better.
And your siblings have told you I'm not playing games. And some of you probably heard about the look. But over the last 4 years, you have come out of that shell. You have taken ownership of your room, and you've left your mark for those students that are going to take your place in you. You're an interesting class because I've had many of your siblings. Two of the Brony brothers, two of the Bobos, three Goldbergs, two Jones, three Sheehans, and two Williams. So that's great. Now, as frustrated as I may get with you on rare occasion, you always manage to put a smile on my face. Most days. You have entertained me more than you will ever know. You've given me stories that I will remember forever, and I will share for many years to come. I may change the names if it belongs to you, or maybe I won't. And yes, some of you have written, in writing, your confessions of poor behavior after being banned to the chair next to the piano for a short period of time. That person is going to remain nameless, but just know it will always hang on my office bulletin board as a reminder to everyone. A few weeks ago, I thought I would come up with at least one memory for each one of you, or something that stands out in my mind. So for the last 3 years, Quinn has stood next to me, my left, at the piano, every single men's sectional choir rehearsal. Every guy in that choir knows that's his spot. They may try to get up there before he gets there, but they know that's his spot. So who is going to take that spot next year? Are you taking applications? No. No one will take that spot. William Sheehan. I think you are the only student in the entire school who calls me Mr. Self. Until yesterday, when you called me D. Self, and I stopped dead in my tracks. I was done. Thank you. William Goldberg. It's the day that you conducted the word building exercise in class. You did a really good job. And then we came December, the last day of school, remember, you did the master class of conducting? You were really, really good. So much that I thought you were itching to take my job. We'll come back to you a little later, though. Jennifer and Maddie. For the longest time, I really thought you hated each other. Your little spats every day. And I would always go home and thinking, how does Maddie not like Jennifer? Or how does Jennifer not like Maddie? I really thought there was going to be an after-school fight on the flagpole one day. Dylan. The day of the water bottle flip. When I flipped it and I got it up there, your reaction was priceless. We had to watch it again a little bit. It was bigger than mine. I will always remember that. You were so excited. Oh, the water bottle flip. Because you continued catching that bottle every time I missed it, and you gave it right back to me. You were not about to let me quit. Thank you. Claire. Claire. Being a featured soloist your freshman year, singing Thinking Out Loud. I just remember thinking how poised and confident for a freshman you were. Tierra. So sweet and gentle and quiet as a freshman, and I thought she would never, ever sing a solo for me. Ever. And we fast forward to March. Featured soloist audition. Here she comes. And you did a solo tonight. I'm very proud of you. In front of a full house. That's great. I remember the look on your face at Tantera junior year. That's a looking thing. Singing with the Allstate Choir. You were in your element. I also remember driving to the lake bed with you that day asking you, why does the choir not like humble and kind? I just don't get it. I remember that. Robbie. You showed up at Featured Soloist Audition this year for the first time ever, not only to audition, but you accompanied yourself. Yeah, that's a wow. That was a wow moment for me, just seeing how far you've come over the last 4 years. I also have the memory of you and Nick trying to get to Prague with me, and we only got as far as Atlanta. That's a story for another day. Oh, Eric. What are you afraid of? I will always remember you sending me your free time. I was blown away by your poise. And your honesty. And since the first day of high school, you have always said what's on your mind. You are no nonsense, and I like that, and you scare me. I know of no other student that loves the Masterworks concert as much as Nick does. Especially the Halloween Fest. So thank you for standing up for good music. You're the one that I can trust to know what's going on around the school and within the classroom. People are drawn to you for your kindness. You're another no-nonsense person when it comes to hard work. Thank you for that. Scruffy. I always think to myself, does Scruffy ever have a bad day? Because you are always so upbeat and so positive. You're a cheerleader for the choir. So your class brings an energy, it's brought an energy to my classroom that's just infectious, and at times it drives me crazy. But you do know how to buckle down and you tackle some great music. So, Will and Will, how many years have we been going out on Friday nights and partying the weekend away? At least?
Three.
So it was just last week one of the underclassmen heard us conversing. They stopped and looked at me and go, is it true that you and Will Goldberg and Will Sheehan go out every weekend? And my response was, oh yeah, every weekend. And I moved on about my business, and I looked at them and I thought, oh, they are totally buying this right now. Thinking, how in the world can a teacher go out and party with the students on the weekend? And I thought, I'd best correct myself right now before I got called in to Ms. Lyle and Mr. Small and asked to explain my weekend adventures with you two. But then I got to thinking, no, you just invite them to go along with us. Right? So I came clean and I shared with them that we did not go out on the weekend. And that actually on Saturday night when I chaperoned the prom at 9 o'clock, I was sitting in my little corner even with the music playing and I was ready to go to sleep. So how can we possibly go out on a Friday and stay out till 7:30 Monday morning? Or do we? Right? It's a secret, okay? But if you guys stop and think about the last 4 years, you probably have spent more time in my classroom any other room in the school. One of the best parts of my job is that I get my students for usually 4 years. That's not a common than any teacher around here, so you probably spent more time with me in that room than anywhere else, and with anyone else. So we get to know each other really, really well. So last week I said I did a little research, and I think if my calculations are correct, if you sang all 4 years of high school, between fall concerts, all the different pieces and the various movements of the Masterworks concert, Spring Thoughts concert, symphonies, other performances, we have worked on 102 different pieces of music in 4 years. That's a lot of music. You will be the next to the last class to hear me attempt to say Agnus Dei on this stage at the conclusion of the concert, when what really came out of my mouth was something other than Agnus Dei. And only one more year, and that will be put to rest. The last class. I thought you were going to be the first class to see me have a complete and total meltdown a couple weeks ago when the lock on my piano was stuck. And I seriously thought they were going to have to cut into it to get it off. Because you know, no one touches my piano. When Mr. Marcheski told me, I mean, we're going to have to cut it off. My heart just about stopped right there, and I put on a calm face, but my heart was just racing a mile a minute. I could not stand still. The outburst of tears is going to come any minute, but they got that lock off. I thought it was going to be a little show. So each of you had the opportunity to share with your audience a little bit about some of your favorite memories, some things that stood out to you. Some of those things that stood out to me was, well, first of all, the water bottle flip. That was a big common one. That was a big one, not only for you, but for me. Will and Sydney dancing together their ninth grade year at this concert. You got on her last nerve. And there were days I really thought she was going to push you off the stage. But truth be told, I think she liked that movie. She did. Quinn's amazing dancing. Especially last year when you took charge of a senior song as a junior, I Lived. I just went back and told her, I watched it yesterday. And you are working that third row. And I watched your faces on the third and fourth row, and you're just loving every minute of it. While the seniors are dancing in front of you, and they have no clue what's going on behind them. I just wish I'd thought to put that in the senior video tonight. For some of you, it's the memories of your extraordinary dance skills, or your lack thereof, or your memories of just getting out there and just dancing and having a good time. Or that moment when the chord clicks, and you realize how good you sound. You realize that moment, the look on your face is priceless. Like the days we sing, I know, I know, I know, I know, we build the chord. Some days it works. Some days it doesn't. Some days the look on your face is, oh yeah. But when it does click, your face is really light up. Now, gentlemen, about this hacky sack moment. I'm not sure how I feel about that. But I want to thank you for sharing it with me. It just tells me that next year I need to start checking in on the men or section rehearsals a little bit more. Lucky them, right? William Goldberg, your directing of the choir. Your conducting skills are just spot. The Masterworks concert, whether it's yelling sleigh ride, or ladies, upsot, in Jingle Bells, or the Hallelujah chorus. Do you remember the first time I gave you the Hallelujah chorus and you looked at it? The look on your face was just priceless, and to be quite honest, it's the look that every ninth grader gives me. It's, yeah, I'm gonna sing this. But what do I tell you? I promise you, you will know it by heart. You will know every single word, and you will never forget it for the rest of your life. And you laugh. But was I right? We could probably sing it right now if we had to. I know it'd be the greatest senior gift I could ever give you. Maybe. Then I got a kick out of one of the comments about the choir reflections. Every time I said, please wait for me to start. And ultimately, four or five of you start. And then the internet crashes, you're one step ahead, but it just shows that dysfunctional people can all make great music together. And then ladies, you're wearing those beautiful choir dresses, trash bags, with your Uggs. I just don't understand. It's like a knife to my heart. But I do love that you've had a really meaningful musical experience, but we've had a lot of fun along the way. So, in closing, before we watch the video, I asked the underclassmen to share some thoughts and memories about you. I want to tell you what they said about you. Colin has been a role model and a great friend. He's always been a reliable companion, a positive role model, and an inspiration to watch in class. I've thoroughly enjoyed singing alongside Cullen. Tierra, from your advice to the inside jokes we shared to many more memories throughout the past 3 years, I've learned so much from you. Thank you for not only being a friend, but being the sister I never had. Claire's leadership in the alto section has led to success in our performances and class every day, and her willingness to work hard and her love for singing has always motivated me and everyone else. If there's one senior who understands how to dance like no one is watching, it's Quinn. His confidence and his positivity is contagious. He's the type of guy who can find the good in just about anyone. Izzy is literally one of the most down-to-earth people I know. Her activism and her general interest in social issues are honestly inspiring. And remember, register to vote. Sometimes in class, I pretend that I'm singing just so I can listen to her for a while because she has the voice of an angel. Will Goldberg never fails to make the class better, whether it be through his dances or his comments that just come to mind and he blurts them out loud. I don't know what they're talking about. I've enjoyed getting to know Will better this year. He's funny, kind of a definition of a leader. And I'm going to add a pretty good conductor. Robbie is a great, great guy. Totally laid back and a great sense of humor. When it comes time to work, he gets the job done. And I'm really glad I got to know him this year. Erica is D-Self 2.0. Her beautiful voice, her hilarious question, and her facial expressions, oh, I know those facial expressions, have made this year in choir very memorable for me. And I'm so happy that I've had the opportunity to sing with her this year. Nicholas has been a role model for our choir class. I'm not sure if a single day has gone by without him telling the basses which note to start on recital. He's the best substitute teacher ever. I won't tell Miss Huber that, but that's him. And I'm quite sure that he would not mind canceling the Spring Pops concert in favor of singing the Hallelujah Chorus on repeat. Savannah is amazing. She comes to class every day with a smile on her face and an energy that is unmatched. She's a leader through example in the alto section and in the choir as a whole. Her choreography is phenomenal, adding depth to the lyrics and making the songs much more enjoyable to perform. Maddie is one of the kindest and most sincere people I have met since coming to this school. She demonstrates respect to everyone, I guess, except for Jennifer, and is a leader by example in all that she does. But I'm afraid that one of these days, she and Jen are going to get into a brawl, and Maddie will win. Sorry, Jen. Dylan can be the funniest guy in the world to talk to if you can keep him still for more than 2 seconds. But if you can accomplish this task, you will have a conversation with one of the most influential seniors in the class of 2018. He makes the class better as a whole, and without him in the choir, we would not have the singing and rapping talents of Dylan's. I honestly don't know how to describe Will Sheehan. He is probably one of the funniest people I've ever met, but he's also one of the nicest people I've ever known. He makes people laugh, and he always makes choir a better class. Sruthi is so energetic and always has a smile on her face. The ultimate choir cheerleader, always speaking well of the group. Next one says, I will never forget the beginning of the year when D-Self asked the altos a question. And without hesitation, Nick, who is not an alto, said, well, it's a Picardy third. So now every time I ask the altos a question, Jennifer says, it's probably a Picardy third. And this person loves it. They say your energy, your dance moves, and your willingness to help the new students in Chamber Choir get better, make you one of the most iconic people to ever grace the Orpheline stage. So it just goes to show you seniors that the younger students do watch, and they do learn from you. You've led by example, and you have set the bar high for next year's seniors. So friends, I just want to say thank you for 4 great years. I hope you find a way to keep singing next year, whether it's in a college choir, university choir, a cappella group, a car, a shower, wherever. just use your voice to make wonderful music. So let's get you recognized. We'll take our last selfie together. Then we'll get on to the video. Deal? Deal. Scott. Surpeaks or pop? So it's time to watch your movie.